In last video, we have seen bit stuffing. In this class, we'll see about character stuffing. Here now, first before discussing this character stuffing, we'll go with this result first, then we'll go with the discussion of this program. Enter a character to be stuffed. Here what character I have mentioned? BBITTA. Actually, this is the character need to be stuffed. Means, this is a message you are transmitting from transmitter to receiver. Here, if you are transmitting your message in the form of packet, where this packet get completes, where another new packet start to arrive. In order to know this, in order to distinguish this by the receiver, what you will do? You will add a starting delimiter as well as end delimiter at the beginning as well as at the end of this message. So here what they have asked, enter a character that represents starting delimiter. You will add that. Here now you can observe that after stuffing you have added A at the beginning. Enter a character that represents end delimiter. You have added B at the end of this stuffed data. And also here you can see after stuffing some of the italic words you have added. What is that italic word means? Actually here your message is what? BBITTA. But you don't have just BBITTA in this. Here what you have done? Here you have added some of the characters here. On what basis you have added? And then what is the reason for adding these characters? So here you are transmitting this character from transmitter end to receiver end to know where this message get completes and where new message get starts. So to know this one, you will add a starting delimiter A as well as end delimiter B. But thing is that here, if sometimes if your character is similar to starting delimiter as well as end delimiter means, receiver get the confusion that this message get completes here only if it is similar to starting delimiter or if it is similar to end delimiter. To avoid this confusion to this receiver, what you will do if you get any of the starting delimiter, your character is similar to starting delimiter or end delimiter means, you will add another character once again. Here we'll see. Your message is BBITTA. Here, first character is what? B. Here, this B resembles similar to end delimiter. So, because of this, what you do? Along with this B, you will add another B. Means you have B, next you have italic style, another B you have. Next character is another B. This character is also similar to end delimiter. So for this B, you will add another B. Next, I, T, T, these three characters will not look similar to starting or end delimiter. You will keep these characters same as it is. Next, you have A. This A is similar to starting delimiter. So because of this A, you will add another A. Next, at the end, you will add end delimiter. So you are sending this message from the transmitter end to receiver end so that receiver will not get any confusion where your message get completes and where your message get start. About this one, it will not get any confusion. So in order to write a C programming for this character stuffing, what I need to do? First, I can ask enter character to be stuffed. First I will ask this. After this one I will enter this one. so that you can store these character in a string. So that in order to enter these characters, you have to make one loop so that it will ask to enter all these characters. Next, you will ask enter a character that represents starting delimiter. Your program will ask this one. In order to ask this one, you can mention another printf statement. Next to scanf statement, you need to mention. After entering the starting delimiter, next you have to enter end delimiter B. After this, you have to check whether your message is similar to starting delimiter or end delimiter. If it is similar, you can add starting delimiter as well as end delimiter once again. So that after stuffing, you will get this message. So we'll go with the program. Here character stuffing. Here we'll mention A of 30, FS of 50, T of 3, this is a temporary variable. Next ST means starting delimiter, EZ means end delimiter. Next somewhere we need some temporary variables. We have represented that one by X of 3, S of 3, D of 3, Y of 3. Next we have mentioned integer variables I, J, P, Q. Fine. First, what question I want to ask? Enter a character to be stuffed. Here I will mention scanf percentage S A. Means you are entering this one as a string. You are storing all these characters as a string. So you no need to have any loop here. This itself make you or allow you to enter all these characters. Whatever character you have entered, all these characters is saved as a string. Next, printf. And here now, a maximum size is 30. Up to 30 character you can enter. Enter a character that represents starting delimiter. Here I have mentioned starting delimiter as A. Next, enter a character that represents ending delimiter. I have mentioned this one as a B. This one will be stored in the variable ED. These two are character types. So you have mentioned this one as a percentage C. Next, you will mention all these things in X of 0, S of 0, S of 1. Next, X of 1, S of 2. S of 2 you have stored with a null character. It represents that your characters get completes here. Similarly, Y of 0, D of 0, D of 1. You have stored end delimiter. And you have stored with a null character. Next, you have one function, strcat. You will draw string concatenation of fs comma x. Here fs means what? Actually, this is also whatever the x character you have. All this x character you have stored in this variable fs. Here x is what? X is starting delimiter along with null character. Means at the beginning you have to store starting delimiter A. That one will be stored in fs. Fine. Next, for I equal to 0, I less than string length, let us consider that you have entered 5 characters. 0 is less than 5. Next, T of 0 equal to A of I. Means A of 0. A of 0 means your first character. That one will be stored in temporary variable T of 0. Next, in T of 1 you have stored null character 0. If T of 0 is starting delimiter, then string concatenation you will do. F of S comma S. Actually here in T of 0 what you have stored? your first character, if this first character is tf0 equal to afi, so tf0 is a first character. If your first character is similar to starting delimiter, then you need to add that one here, string concatenation of f of s comma s. Here s means what? Here you can observe s means what? In s of 0 and s of 1, what he has stored? Starting delimiter. Means if your starting delimiter is a, and if your character is also a, means you have to store a two times. That one will be stored here. a two times will be stored here. Else if tf0 is equal to n delimiter, then n delimiter will be added two times. So you have done string concatenation of fs comma d. Here in d, what you have stored? df0 and df1 will be of n delimiter. So here you will add n delimiter two times. Else if your character is not that of starting delimiter as well as n delimiter, then what you will do? String concatenation of fs comma t. Means in temporary variable you have stored what is your character. That character will be stored in this fs. In fs already what you have? Starting delimiter you have added. Next character you have added. If that character is similar to starting delimiter, you have to add that two times. If this character is similar to n delimiter, you have to add this n delimiter character two times, and that one will be stored in this fs. And if it is not resemble similar to starting or end, then that character will be kept same as it is. So here in last else, now you can observe that if it is not similar to starting or end delimiter, you will add this one. So we will do this one, we will do this operation till all the character, that one will be checked with whether this is similar to starting or end element. As all these character will be stored in this fs, next what you will do? String concatenation of fs comma y. What is here? Y means y contains your end delimiter, because at the end of this stuffed data you have to add end delimiter. So that end delimiter will be added here, end delimiter along with null character will be added. So whatever this character stuff data you had done, that one will be stored in fs. So printf, after stuffing, what is that string will be there? That one you can display, that fs will be displayed. So with respect to this example, you can analyze this program. Thank you. In next class we will discuss about next program.